On June 4, 2020, India and Australia signed a historic agreement, which was signed between Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison. Although seven agreements were signed between the two countries, but the most important agreement was defense agreement, which allows India and Australia to use each other's naval bases. The main aim of the agreement is that India could use Australia's Cocos Island in the Pacific Ocean and Australia could use India's Andaman and Nicobar Island in the Indian Ocean. Well, there is growing tension between India and China in Ladakh and between United States of America and China in the South China Sea. This agreement sends China a clear signal that Australia stands with India and the US against China. The purpose of the agreement between India and Australia is to strengthen Indian and Australian defenses to block Chinese entry into the Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean from South China Sea. India has similar agreements with the United States of America, France, Singapore and South Korea. These countries can use India's ports and naval bases and vice versa. A similar defense agreement is likely to be signed between India and Japan very soon. Meanwhile, in December 2019, Japan had purchased a 3.2 square mile island for £113 near Okinawa in the East China Sea to set up a military base in response to growing threats from China. This island will be used by the US aircraft carrier and their fighter jets to carry out military exercises. US 7th Fleet is already in the South China Sea. It is stationed near Japan and is carrying out military exercises. US 7th Fleet consists of about 70 ships, 40,000 sailors and 300 aircraft. US Navy is patrolling the South China Sea, where China lays 90% claim on the South China Sea. Other countries in the South China Sea, including Malaysia, Singapore, Brunei, Indonesia, Vietnam and Philippines, are also patrolling alongside US warships. On the other hand, US 5th Fleet is stationed in the Persian Gulf, is kept in readiness to move to the Indian Ocean to cover China and block China in the South China Sea from its western end. US 5th Fleet consists of about 35 to 40 ships, 100 aircrafts and 20,000 sailors. On the other hand, Indian Naval Fleet is also in full readiness, which is presently covering Pakistan's Karachi port and would be ready to move closer to the Indian shores in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands in the Indian Ocean. Indian naval ships are also deployed in Mauritius, Maldives and Seychelles in the Indian Ocean to safeguard India's backyard. Thus, in the South China Sea, China will be encircled from its eastern end by Japanese and Korean Navy, supported by US 7th Fleet, and it's on its western front by US 5th Fleet. US 7th Fleet will also cover part of Pacific Ocean, and US may shift its 7th Fleet to western part of South China Sea and 5th Fleet to the eastern part of South China Sea. Already three US aircrafts are in the South China Sea and in the Pacific Ocean close to China. US has a total of 11 aircraft carriers compared to one by India and one by China. Behind US defenses will be Indian Navy with 180 strong Indian naval force, including aircraft carrier Vikramaditya, which will ensure that Chinese ships or submarines do not come out of South China Sea and will be stationed all along the Indian Ocean and patrol the surrounding areas. Then there will be joint Australian and Indian naval fleet guarding the Pacific Ocean behind US fleet to check any Chinese misadventure. Thus, it will be a complete blockade of trade and other routes for Chinese naval and commercial ships in case there is war between China and the US or China and India or China and South Korea or Japan. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.